Hi, this is Linda Aronson from Unleashed to Learn, and it's my pleasure today to be with Barrett Nowicki, who is the founder of the Center for Emotive Agility, which is in East Hampton, Massachusetts. And the two of us met up, what was it, just like a couple weeks ago, at the Valley Mentors Program and for entrepreneurs in the Accelerated Night, and we saw all kinds of pitches, elevator pitches, and all kinds of things. Very motivating, very exciting for those who really want to get going on their entrepreneurial enterprise. Barrett holds a Bachelor's of Humanities in Arts and Psychology and Drama from Carnegie Mellon, as well as has a Master's of Art in Emotion Studies and Physical Theater from New York University. I'm just going to read this because I love this. This is right off her website. Barrett has always felt strongly that there are elements of actor training that can be extracted from theater and utilized in everyday life to enrich everyday interactions. I love that.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about how emotive agility was created, and tell us about your background and how it all came into being.
Sure. So at Carnegie Mellon, it was purely academic and less experiential. It was the concept that theater and psychology are inherently connected, that they should be connected, that there are so many ways to connect them.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, so I love that they offered this program, which was a dual degree, and it was, I was in the conservatory with the directing students, with the directors at the drama school,
wow.
And I was simultaneously able to take classes at the psychology, in the school of psychology, so focused on social psychology, emotion, and relationships. It was a very research-oriented school. So fusing those two in undergrad, I wrote a couple of papers, and I was very attracted to the way that specific theater directors would train their actors, and I would be reading about it, not with the performance in mind, but thinking, wow, this is amazing for the actor as a person. So undergrad, it was purely academic. It was just a thirst that I had to blend these two fields. Yeah.
So it's kind of like an alchemy.
So I had to find a way to align that with outside of theater, and because of my social psych background during grad school, I found a specific definition of emotional intelligence by Peter Salovey at Yale, and I aligned and modified the Rosenbaum's technique, added some other theater exercises, and aligned the goals of that technique with this specific emotional intelligence definition. And that fusion is emotive agility.
All of that is so
That's how I was born.
Yeah. All right. Just to back up a little bit, because I myself am not familiar with the RASA boxes, and I did read on your website about that. Do you want to just share briefly about what that is? It's obviously very experiential, and it sounded like that was a real light bulb for you about it all coming together.
It was, especially because it was influenced by Grotowski, and I was like, oh, that's my guy. Like, that's what I want to do.
Right.
So RASA, in a word, RASA is a principle of Indian Kathakali theater, and RASA, it literally, it's a Sanskrit word. It means the transmission of my emotion to you, if I'm doing it justice. So when I make a face like you start to feel that emotion, or you receive my emotion. However you receive my emotion, RASA is the transmission of the emotion. So there are eight RASIC energies, eight basic RASAs that correspond to each emotion.
Okay.
And in the RASA boxes, you've got a grid of nine boxes on the floor with painter's tape, and the actor moves from one to the next, experiencing the emotions in a physical way throughout their whole physicality.
Wow.
These can be blended together to make more complex emotions. The intensity could be brought up or brought down to make them more true to life. And this is a great arena to practice for everyday
life.
Yeah. Like the basic ingredients of a cake, but there are emotions, and you can blend them. And
oh wow, that's amazing.
Woo. I coined it in order to describe to describe the answer to what do you do. I help people increase their emotive agility.
Right.
I help them improve their emotive agility.
Right.
So I came to realize that, you know, in teaching workshops on emotive agility, I came up with a definition. Is this kind of what you're asking? Like, how did it? Yeah.
Yes.
So I came up with a definition of emotive agility, which is a quality It's kind of taking emotional intelligence just to another level. Emotional intelligence is all about how we, our mind interacts with emotions. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't involve the body. It involves how you conceive of emotions while you're making decisions. Mm-hmm. It's a big pop term. But emotive agility is the ability to align your emotion with your intellect through your face, posture, breath, movement, and tone of voice.
So it's really the mind, emotion, and body, mm-hmm. which is very integrated.
Super integrated, yes.
All right. Tell us a little bit about your experience in working with people with emotive agility. I mean, you've worked all the way from fairly young preschoolers all the way up to those in college.
Yes.
And graduate school.
And graduate school, yeah.
So you want to talk a little bit about your experience with that?
Sure. Started out with adults. I started out, since emotional intelligence is highly placed in the professional development world, mm-hmm. I started out doing emotive agility with adults. And that, it always surprised me how much adults would open up. Because I was very cautious of not being the crazy acting lady who's coming in and making you scream and run around the room. Very cautious of that. Because I knew that wouldn't fly, and it's not me either.
Right, right.
So I took away any sense of improvisation from emotive agility to make it more structured, to really use, so with adults, I was really surprised how, you know, willing they were to just jump into, you know, into different emotion positions. And what a revelation it is for people, hearing from adults, you know, that don't ever otherwise have a chance to talk about it.
Absolutely. And you were smart to play it, you know, without, like you said, jumping in too far.
Yeah.
And letting them kind of lead you. And at what point did you decide to take this on an entrepreneurial path? As opposed to maybe looking for some kind of a job that you could maybe bring in some of these elements into?
Great question. Great question.
I think the answer is in the question. But
no, yes. Okay. Well, it triggers me to remember that my mom would always say to me, well, there must be some company that will want you to do this.
Right.
Not that you reminded me of her in that question, but it makes me think, what, you know, why I was thinking about that on the way over here, like why entrepreneurial versus like trying to align with something else. Not that I don't want to collaborate.
Sure.
Yeah, I actually do, but I knew I was an entrepreneur when I couldn't conceive of this in any other way.
Is one of your hopes that by giving young people the experience of emotive agility that it may prevent some things, you know, that are hot buttons today, like bullying and things like that? That there's this, what are my choices here, what am I feeling, what are my choices?
I think there's a danger right now that we are losing our ability, we are losing our emotive agility. I feel like right now in society, kids are growing up with less emotive agility. Grown-ups are losing emotive agility. I think it has a lot to do with the screen time. So a major goal, the purpose, you know, of the outcome, the desired outcome of putting a child through an emotive agility training or program would be increased ability to develop human connections, right. And increased ability to navigate social situations. Mm-hmm. So deeper connections and better relationships.
Uh-huh. In terms of this, what, you know, we've talked a little bit about your immersion experience, but what other characteristics do you think you really need to have to pull off the entrepreneurial?
Oh, I read somewhere, and I agree with it, that you have to be like, optimistic almost to an irrational point. And that has gotten me through a lot of times when I've thought like, oh, maybe I shouldn't do this, maybe I should get a job like my mom is worried about. Like, you know, no, like, you know, not, I meant it, like a job with a
yes.
big company or
yes,
something.
Yes, I understand.
Yeah, so that you almost have to be irrationally optimistic. So I didn't come up with that, but I have an affinity to that.
Yes.
to just, yeah, I think that, and then, you have to make your own schedule. Like, time management is something I've struggled with, and when I got it down, it feels amazing. You know, like, I've struggled with, like, oh my god, the day's already gone.
Okay,
right. Yeah, I'm tired. Like, yeah, but then when you get it down, it feels incredible. So I don't think you I think the best, you know, entrepreneurs, obviously they don't sleep, or they sleep on a very good schedule.
How through entrepreneurship you can combine things or create things, invent things that, you know, previously didn't exist. And why not? You know, rather than having to get permission, just go do it, you know.
Absolutely. And I think the academic side, being allowed to blend both of my degrees, not have a double major, but actually invent my own major, I feel like then, like I said, no one said, oh, now you should be an entrepreneur with that. The next natural progression, the only thing that feels comfortable for me is being an entrepreneur. And I think it's because of that academic openness to just blend. What would you like to blend? And there was guidance around it in undergrad. There was guidance around it in graduate school. And I manifested different unique things. That was a great supplement to what I did. Yeah.
Excellent. Yeah. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
This has been wonderful. And you are irrationally optimistic. And I love it. I love your energy.
Thank you, Linda.
And I'm sure that just your energy is going to bring them all on. And you're going to be a very busy lady.
That's so great.
And I wish you the best for your summer program, too, for your children.
Thank you. Fantastic.